Police Minister Lisa Neville has now shed some light as to the decision-making process which actually led to that private security firm manning the program.
Yeah, that's right, Ash. Some light has been shed, but we still don't have an answer to that exact question of who made the decision to use private security guards in hotel quarantine instead of the ADF or police. Now, Lisa Neville is the police minister here in Victoria. She's been giving evidence this afternoon. She says she first became aware that private security were going to be used in a 2 p.m. Phone meeting with Emergency Commissioner Andrew Crisp and Police Commissioner, who was then Graham Ashton. She says that Andrew Crisp came into this meeting with the decision that private security guards were going to be used, although she says she can't say if it was Mr. Crisp himself who made that decision. Now, we know from Mr. Ashton's evidence that prior to this, he was unaware that private security guards were going to be used, although he certainly at the time expressed a view that it was his preference that private security be used in lieu of police. Minister Neville, though, said today that in ultimately making the decision to use private security, the police commissioner, Graham Ashton, should have been consulted. Take a listen.
Would you have expected that a decision about who the front line of security would be for an operation of this kind would have been a decision made either by or in consultation with the Chief Commissioner?
My expectation would that it should have been made in consultation with the Chief Commissioner.
What would have been your expectation about whether you were informed or consulted about the merits of competing proposals?
If there had been any serious consideration of Victoria Police playing a significant role in hotel quarantine program, it is my view I would have been consulted.
Ash, Minister Neville is continuing to give her evidence this afternoon. We're just getting on to the topic of the ADF, specifically that request from Andrew Crisp in mid-June to the ADF for 850 personnel, a request that was rescinded just hours after it was made. Lisa Neville, the police minister, says she was unaware of that request until after it had been rescinded, but in hindsight, she would like to have been aware of it earlier. Earlier today as well, we heard from Jobs Minister Martin Pakula, who said that responsibility for the hotel quarantine program ultimately lay not with his Department of Jobs but with the Department of Health and Human Services. Tomorrow we will hear from Health Minister Jenny Markakos before Premier Daniel Andrews takes the stand on Friday.
Patrick Murrell, thank you. We'll let you get back to watching the rest of the inquiry.